Hello students, welcome to this class of operation research. Okay, so in last class we have studied about slack variables. Okay, so until now we have seen that how we solve the linear programming problems graphically, right? And we discussed in last class that we can't solve every problem graphically, right? Let's say we have more than two variables, then it is impossible to solve that problem graphically because we have only two coordinates that could be drawn in on a paper, right? So graphically we can't see or we can't imagine the solutions. So we need some other method, some other analytical method which can be used to optimize the problem. What is that method? That is the simplex method. Okay, so basically from this lecture and for further 4 or 5 lectures we will see what is simplex method, right? And how it is used to optimize the problem or to find the maximum profit or minimum cost. Okay, so what's written over here? Graphical method of LP can't be used if number of variables is more than two simplex, is more than two, right? And simplex method is used for it. Okay, so basically simplex method is an iterative method. Okay, what it means? Simplex method is an iterative method. So how simplex method works, we will see, however. But yeah, it involves various iterations, right? Like there is a certain process that we will go through, then we will have iteration one. Then after first iteration, we will again go through the same process. We will see what are those steps that we have to go through. But yeah, then we will again go through those steps, then we will have iteration two, right? And we will keep repeating this until we reach the optimized solution. How we will know whether the solution has been optimized? We will see in further steps that how to know that yeah, our solution has already been optimized. Okay, so now let's see, we will consider this example. So this is my main function. See, z is equal to 3x1 plus 4x2, right? This is my objective function. This is my objective function. So you know that objective function needs to be optimized. Be it a maximize or be it a minimization problem, here we are given that it's a maximization problem. So our task is to maximize the z. And what are the constraints? X1 plus x2 should be less than or equal to 450, and 2x1 plus x2 should be less than or equal to 600. X1 should be greater than or equal to 0 and x2 should be greater than or equal to 0. So these are all the constraints given to us. So you know, so this is a 2D equation. Basically you will say that, sir, we can solve it graphically. Yeah, well, we can solve it graphically, but now from now on we will solve it using the simplex method. We will see how simplex method will help us solve this equation. Okay, so now let's see what are the various steps. So yeah, now from here on we will see one by one. First of all, express the problem in standard form. Okay, so you must remember that in last class we have studied about slack variables. Now there is the main use of slack variables in simplex method. What we will do, what we have done in last class, we have removed the inequalities, right? Like here we have those inequalities, right? So what we will do, we will remove the inequalities. How? We will introduce slack variables s1 and s2. What I will do? X1 plus x2 plus s1 is equal to 450, and next I will write 2x1 plus x2 plus s2 is equal to 600. So here I have introduced s1 and s2 as slack variables. Okay, and similarly I will introduce it in my objective function. How? Z will be equal to 3x1 plus 4x2 plus 0 of s1 plus 0 of s2. So technically up till now it has no role to play in my objective function because its coefficient is 0, but it will get modified when we do the iterations. You know, we have just discussed that we will do the various iterations. So when we will do the iterations, we will see the various steps, then this coefficient will keep on changing. Okay, so we will see how. So this is my first step. I have written the problem in standard form. How? I have introduced the slack variables in both my constraint equations, and I have introduced the both slack variables in my objective function. Okay. Yeah, slack variables are also called the basic variables. Keep this in mind, it's very important. Why it is called basic variables? Because it gave us the initial basic feasible solution. Okay, we will see it further. But yeah, slack variables are called the basic variables. Okay. And x1 and x2 are called decision variables or non-basic variables. Decision variables or non-basic variables. Okay. And yeah, keep in mind one thing, that the RHS of the equation must be positive. That the right hand side of the equation that we are writing for to use it in simplex method, it must be positive. In case you have a negative value on the right hand side, then what we will do? We will multiply the whole equation by minus 1. So to get the simplex method to work, its right hand side must be positive. Okay. So if it is negative, multiply throughout by minus 1. Yeah. Moving on. What's the next step? Slack variables or basic variables are unutilized capacity or resources. Okay. So what it's saying, that what does slack variables signify? Okay. What it's saying us, what's the use of those slack variables? We have discussed in last class also what slack variables was saying, worth mentioning. Slack, the meaning of slack variables is that the coefficient of slack variable shows us that how much it will impact my objective function. Okay, how much it will impact my objective function. So these contribution to the objective function, that is zero. Presently it's zero because we have the coefficients 0s1 plus 0s2, but further on while doing the iterations, their role will come into play because the coefficient will start changing, and we'll see how much they are contributing to my objective function, my slack variables. Okay, yeah. So yeah, this is basically the pre-written problem, right, that I have written here. This is nothing but basically the same thing, right? X1 plus X2 plus S1 is equal to 450, 2X1 plus X2 plus S2 is equal to 600, and this is my main function. Okay, so now, so this was our first task. Now this is ready. Now this thing is ready for use in simplex method. Okay, so this is your first step. Now keep it in mind, few things that you have to keep in mind. Your first step is introduce slack variables and remove inequality. Okay, this is your first step. Introduce slack variables and remove inequality. Okay. And then rewrite the objective function. Okay, rewrite the objective function. How? By introducing the S1 and S2 and keeping its coefficients to zero. Now two more things that you have to keep in mind here. X1 comma X2 are decision variables. These are called decision variables, or we are also called them non-basic variables. Okay, similarly S1 comma S2 are basic variables, or we call them slack variables. So this was the first step. You must understand this, that while doing the problem, solving the problem graphically, we directly plotted those equations, but to make them capable or make them visible to be get used in simplex method, we need to modify those equations by introducing slack variables. Okay, we rewrite all the equations. I hope that you get until this point. We will go very slowly, step by step, so that you will fully understand the simplex method. So further on, I will continue next class. We will meet later. Okay.